From University of California, San Diego. Today, I'm gonna present my face altus AR, altus of facial acupuncture points in augmented reality. You may be familiar with acupuncture. Clinicians insert thin needles into your body, probably to relieve type of pain, like low back pain, neck pain, and even just a cosmetic purpose. In traditional Chinese medicine, acupuncture is one of the primary methods of treatments. It's based on a system of meridians where energy flows inside. Along the meridians lie acupuncture points, or we call it acupoints. Inserting needles into these points with appropriate combination is said to bring the energy flow back into proper balance. Recent research attempts to demonstrate the objective existence of these meridians with the use of modern technologies. Only a few months ago, by injecting those fluorescent dyes in the acupuncture points in the pericardium, they even captured a fluorescent migratory path that approximately along the meridian. But acupuncture itself has been practiced for more than 2,000 years. Then how did they localize the acupuncture in clinics? Dated back to 1,000 years ago, the medical college prototyped this life-size model, the bronze man, for their students to practice acupuncture. The model was covered with wax and filled with water. Thus, during their final exam, students sealed the holes, and if the water came out, they got the points. Then the bronze model becomes professional medical procedure training model with skin-like materials. Moreover, like other healthcare training, after a lot of practice, they could finally apply the needles to a simulated patients before they play to actual patients. And most recently, with the development of virtual reality, they create acupuncture training program that integrates the detailed anatomy model and the meridian system. We could see the trend that the modern training progress emphasize more anatomical information, which is the most accurate localization method. This staircase is a summary of acupoint localization review that includes 771 studies. For researchers, they push the accuracies as much as possible to stair 4 to measure the skin impedance, and stair 5 anatomy level, probably with the help of the medical imaging. However, as the precision steps forward, the feasibility drops. Therefore, different methods just suit for different scenarios. For example, when someone gets sudden motion sick on the car, he may massage the neiguan acupoints. To find this pressure point, he places the first three fingers, which indicates two tendons, and feel the tendon and tenderness on the wrist, which here is the stair 1 and stair 3. Acupuncturists usually prefer stair 2 plus stair 3 in their clinics. The difference is that the proportional bone method involves anatomical information, and current standardized acupoints definition are based on the method plus one more clear anatomical description. Also, those training process we mentioned earlier, they also use stair 2 or stair 2 plus stair 3 to annotate a standard model. Besides making it more accurate, another research direction for us is to localize and visualize the acupoints on individuals, specifically for students and those people without any medical background. Augmented reality can provide the new experience by superimposing the virtual information onto the real-world objects. Here, the aim is that in AR, you turn on the camera and the acupuncture points will be displayed right on the face. To achieve this, Jiang first proposed the acuglass, which is based on the Google Glass. For localization, they use only the face head width and the distance between the eyes for reference, which are too limited to adapt to different people and different poses of the face. Other works like Chen in 2017 and Lang in 2018, they first annotate a standard 3D face model, and then fitted 3D morphable face model, which we called a 3DMM, to a 2D image and combine facial landmarks and the image deformation to estimate those acupoints. However, the 3DMM method is based on the principal component analysis, which limits the range of possible predictions by the linear manifold spanned by the PCA physicists. Therefore, the diversity of the set of faces captured for the model affects the final polygonal mesh results very well. In summary, manual annotation on a standard 3D model may not correctly fit all kinds of people and different poses. Moreover, acupoints are officially defined relative to the landmarks, while the deformation process does not guarantee those relativeness. So to obtain such landmarks that can determine the acupoints by proportional Bowen method, we need to first find a solution that could identify enough semantic landmarks that geometry structures of the human faces. This technology is called face alignment. From a Bullen's review in 2017, existing 2D and 3D datasets annotates only a limited set of the landmarks. For example, this 300W, this is the most widely used in the wild datasets for 2D alignments. It annotates only 6 to 8 landmarks per face. And on the right, Intel RealSync, which is a 3D input, sensor, which most of the cell phone does not engage, tracks only 78 landmarks. These landmarks either have distinct semantics of their own or participate in a meaningful facial contour. So our aim is to create an Android application to display acupoints on a user's face accurately in real time. This application runs in augmented reality with clinical acupuncture points localization method and adapts to different people in different poses. With this face sensors AR, people who have little or no medical knowledge can use to do acupressures on themselves. The facial acupoints localization solution consists of an offline stage and an online stage. So first, during the offline stage, we do the model selection. We choose to blend a pre-trained face alignment model together with a pre-trained hair segmentation model. This is because a single model cannot cover the whole set of the target regions on the face, while different parts of the regions are in different parts of the different systems. Then we do the acupuncture localization. We use the proportional Bowen measurements method to locate all the acupoints on the face. Finally, to generate a config file, this file contains all the information needed for each acupoint or a reference point. And the information includes name, regions, relative locations, usually towards a landmarks or a reference point. Then at the online stage, the system gets face landmarks together with the hair segmentation results and merge those results into acupoints generator. The acupoints generator gives out the requested acupoints on the frame based on the prior knowledge and then draw it onto the input face. This whole process is implemented via the media pipe. It is an open source cross-platform framework from Google to build multimodal machine learning pipeline. It bridges the gap between the face alignment and AR applications so that our system could work perfectly on phone without any extra hardware. In MediaPipe framework, our perception pipeline is structured as a graph with modular components. Each component, called a calculator, solves an individual task like the model inference, data transformation, or annotation. From the graph, we see that with camera as input, and after all the operations and perceptions, it generates the augmented frames as output. The process here is divided into majorly two subgraphs, one for the face alignment, face landmarks from GPU, and the other for the hair segmentation, we call it hair segmentation GPU. The first subgraph face alignment comprises of mainly three steps. First, for the face detection, the whole frame is first processed by a lightweight face detector to get the face bounding box and then several landmarks, thus to get the rotation matrix of the face. These steps only runs until the system finds its face to finds a face to check, or the system lose tracking and to try to recheck. And then do the image transformation. The image is then cropped by a bounding box and resized to fit into the next step. After this step, the target region is centered aligned, obviously normalized. Finally, the face landmark generation. The pre-trained model produces a vector of the 3D landmarks coordinates, which subsequently get mapped back into the original image coordinate system. Then, from a canonical face mesh model, we extract those vertices with semantic meanings at the reference point. The other subgraph is to get hair segmentation mask. Because the center of the frontal hairline is a critical facial anatomical landmarks according to the national standard. Note that the mask generated from the previous round of the inference will be embedded at the alpha channel here together with the RGB images to feed back to the loop again. And this process, this additional channel information helps to accelerate the whole process. Given the hair mask together with the face landmarks, we now could locate those facial acupoints based on the proportional bone method. This method first defined a unit cun on different parts of the body. And the value of unit cun is the length between the set of two bone nodes divided into certain equal parts at the basis for setting acupoints. For example, here the head is determined as 9 tun, and here as 3, and here as 12 tun. And for us, the facial acupoints bank on the unit tun definition of the head as shown in the figure. To start with, we locate those three facial anatomical landmarks in the consonance with the national standards. In order to differentiate those three points to other acupoints, we group them into a channel called RHD. So RHD is created by us for the reference points only. It's not actually, it's not all actually acupoints. Here we create RHD1 for internal acupoint, RHD2 for the middle of the anterior hairline, and RHD3 are two pupils. On that occasion, like the RHD points definition, we could locate all other facial acupoints. Table 1 shows an example of acupoint spy, which illustrates what information we keep for each for all the acupoints. There are in total 12 standard and 8 extraordinary meridians, while acupuncture points are the chosen site on the meridian system. So for us, the visualization, we also group the acupoints on the same meridian channel and connect them by the flow, like this. Beside them, below the meridian, we also annotate it with a corresponding region and code it localization expression here. So all the points information finally makes up to this data file. The file is designed to be readable for non-technical users. For example, we could ask acupuncturists to manually crack the less accurate acupoints descriptions by just a natural language. We achieved real-time performance on both the desktop and mobile devices by designing the pipeline properly. The main application runs on a Android device. Here shows a set of screenshots from, this is from Samsung Galaxy S10 smartphone. And each screenshot which shows a set of acupoints grouped by and connected by its meridian in different poses. From this picture, we can see that the system tolerates to different angles and to some extent. And for those points on the side face here or here, it will be more accurate if you turn the head a little bit to make that part of the face towards the front camera. where in the same time you can still see that because you use the front camera to see yourself. So usually the occlusion on the face would be a big issue. The occlusions such as the hair, the glasses, and fingers, fingers will try to target at the specific point. And thanks to the robustness of the face alignment towards the occlusion, users would not find any problem pointing or pressing a target point. We also set up an experiment to validate the accuracy by localizing four reference points and 69 acupuncture points on the face and comparing the mean pixel errors between the ground truth positions and the localization results. Initially, we assigned all the target positions into three groups by the localization complexity as shown in this table. We then investigate the mean pixel errors in three groups. For each localization point, we measure the pixel errors in four different poses. For the front face pose, pitch in XX, and roll in Y axis, yaw in Z axis to get the mean value. From the results, we found that some of the localization are less precise than others. Especially the system performs worse on group two than group one and worse on group three than the group two. Accordingly, which means that the multiple times of the proportional calculation that rely on this twin system add inaccuracies to these results. And also which means a target point will be more well localized when it is a point that's straight to camera without any angles. We evaluated the performance of our pipeline in three major components. First is a face alignment and hair segmentation and acupoints generation. Since the application runs on the multiple platforms, we compare its performance on desktop with NVIDIA GeForce RTX 2070 Super and a Samsung S10 with Adreno 660. The input images for two TF-like models are both in the full size of 512 by 512. We see that in this case, Samsung S10 still runs in full frame rate, which means 60 FPS to keep it real time and fluent smoothly. More detailed comparisons are in this table. We also evaluate the performance of data file parsing on the table three, which only runs once at the setup stage. So it is good to accept. A little bit extension of this work is future works. That is another piece that we are currently actively working on. This is the aim for this piece is to better localize the acupoints on the ear region. Because within the ear region, there are dozens of acupuncture points around the ears that represent specific domains and functions of the body. Also, it would be a great extension and supplement to existing face alignment model because, you know, because they usually pay less attention to the semantic meanings of the face borders, which resulting in the actual inaccuracies for the acupoints in those subregions. And to conclude that, in this paper, we propose a face autos AR and end-to-end facial acupoints tracking solution that achieves real-time performance on mobile devices. Our pipeline integrates a face alignment model with a hair segmentation model. The high accuracy of the estimation and the robustness of the system empower users with little experience in acupuncture to interact with their facial acupoints. It tolerates the movements and very well and endures tilt and rotations to some degree. So this is the end of my presentation. If you are interested in our work or have further questions, please feel free to contact me.